Hello, everybody. Welcome back to the channel. And so I've been kind of vocal about the Pixel 7a having a very big problem that I foresee coming a little bit after launch. It has nothing to do that it's going to be buggy or anything like that, but really what it has to do with is just the masses' perception of this phone. Now, one would argue and say that, the pricing that is said to be at $499 for the phone. And people are like, well, the Galaxy A54 sells for $499. But my way of thinking and the way that I've seen this always go down every year is the same thing, is that Apple will get a pass, Samsung will get a pass, but Google will be critiqued severely. Now, when you look at the rumored specifications of the Pixel 7a, basically it is almost identical to the Pixel 7, pretty much just undercutting the reason for even buying a Pixel 7 this year. If you wanted to get a new device, there are just some very, very minor differences between the Pixel 7a and the Pixel 7. And this is just one of those things that where I foresee people saying that what you're getting is not a whole lot. So why is it raised up from $449 to $499? And this is one of the things that, I agree with some of the other creators that are speaking on this. And that is when you kind of look at it, we wanted wireless charging on the A series devices. We wanted 90 hertz refresh because that was the biggest problem last year with the Pixel 6a that I thought was just ridiculous. But a lot of people went ahead and still complained about it. No 90 hertz refresh, only 60 hertz refresh. This is supposed to be a mid-range budget option for those people to get the Pixel experience without spending what it would cost for the flagship counterparts, right? Now we already have the flagship baseline being at $599. So even then, that could be, is the Pixel 8 going to be bumped up to $699 and the Pixel 8 Pro bumped up to $999? Like, these are the things that I think about when it comes down to just the pricing scheme for these devices. We wanted to have a mid-range device replace flagship by giving flagship specifications, but expect a mid-range? Like, that is insane. That's crazy. And when you expect something like that, you're going to see a price increase. So my only hope is that what the Pixel 7a is bringing to the table, if people are okay with the Galaxy A54 mid-range, basically, I feel like that then at the same time they should be okay with the Pixel 7a. But if you're going to critique the hell out of the Pixel 7a, just remember, you wished for this. You wanted this because the way that the A series devices were before, I had no problem with it when it just mainly focused on bringing that good Pixel experience and not so much trying to give you like a flagship. That's my thoughts on this. But what are your guys' thoughts? Let me know in the comment section. Sound off. Smash the like button to help circulate this video. Thanks for checking it out, and I'll talk to you on the next one.